Why do we need a sunscreen? A sunscreen is going to protect us from UV rays, both UVA and UVB. We know that those rays can be damaging in terms of continued exposure, leading eventually to the development of skin cancer. And further to that, we've come to understand that exposure to UV rays also contribute to photoaging. What we've discovered now is that visible light also requires protection. And newer sunscreens will incorporate this into their protective spectrum by means of physical filters. It can be difficult to find over-the-counter preparations of physical sunscreens that go on without leaving a residue thereafter. I think ones to look out for are Bioderma as well as Avène. I like the Bioderma particularly because it has a nice nanoparticle technology, and that means it doesn't give you that greyish or whitish residue after application. It comes in three colors, so nicely adapted across various skin tones, goes in very lightly, rapidly absorbed, no residue thereafter. Avène also does a physical filter that's nicely tolerated. Chemical filter sunscreens include ingredients like avobenzone and oxybenzone. If you are using a chemical filter sunscreen, just be mindful to apply 20 minutes before exposure because it does take some time to activation. Chemical filter sunscreens I like that are over the counter include Bioderma's Photoderm Max, and this is their aqua fluid. It's a nice light preparation. Again, benefit is here, it's water resistant as well. And you'll see it goes on with a really nice finish. For kids, the one I like is from Bioderma's Photoderm for Kids. And the reason I like it is you'll see it has a bit of a blue tint in it. And because it's got this blue tint, you know exactly where you're applying over face and body, so you don't skip any areas. Your child may look a little like a smurf for a few moments, but that goes away very nicely, you'll see. So it's a nice safety mechanism built into the sunscreen. And finally, we get asked very often, does everybody need a sunscreen? And the answer is quite simply, yes. Especially toward your more olive or browner complexions. Remember, a concern for us is often post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation or an increase in pigmentation. And all this means is, should you have an inflammatory process, something as simple as an acne, an eczema, you are more prone to pigmentation thereafter on healing. And so if you want to prevent the progression of this pigmentation, a sunscreen is a really important part in your skincare routine. So I've touched on sunscreen is for everyone. Another important thing to remember is sunscreen is for every day. That means even on grey, cloudy days, sunscreen is really important because UV, you know, is invisible. So even a grey, cloudy day is a sunscreen day. Even a day indoors is a sunscreen day. You'll remember UVB is stopped by glass, but UVA comes through most happily. So especially if you're sitting alongside a window, be mindful that sunscreen still needs to be applied. I hope you've liked our recommendations on sunscreen. We wish you happy summer days and share with us some of your tips on sunscreen. We'd love to hear them. We'd love to hear which sunscreens you like in particular as well.